Hello and welcome to this guide to eDrawings. We're going to step through five topics during this guide. We're going to take a look at what an eDrawing is, how to create one, how to then use them, how to share them with people, and also take a look at some functions in Edrawings Professional. So let's start off with what an eDrawing is. eDrawings is a fast, reliable, and convenient way to open and view many 3D models and 2D drawings created by widely used CAD systems. eDrawings Standard comes with a range of tools to allow you to interrogate the 3D design data, such as measurements, creating markups and cross-sections, along with other options to view existing animations as well as simulation results. eDrawings Professional extends the functionality by allowing you to open your models in a virtual reality environment. For more information on eDrawings, or just a reminder, be sure to check out the product pages on our website. There's a handy video to give you a quick overview of the product in action. Okay, so hopefully you all know what an eDrawing is now. Let's take a look at how we create them. Let's drop into SOLIDWORKS. We have an assembly model of a prosthetic foot. The easiest way to get this into eDrawings is to simply use the File menu and choose Publish to eDrawings. We get an option to choose the configuration. We only have one in this example. We also have an option to include an attachment. Now the attachment is a step file, so one of the three formats of step file. This is useful if the model needs to be sent to a manufacturing team, a stakeholder, and they need to access a neutral format file for producing manufacturing data from. I'll leave that on for now to show an example. We also have some options to be aware of. This includes things like being able to measure the file. So if you do not want the recipient to be able to measure the file, you can deselect the option. I'll leave it on here for the moment. We can also allow or disable STL export for parts and assemblies again. So if this model needs to be sent to someone who is perhaps going to 3D print it, an STL is normally the file type of choice for that scenario. We can enable that from eDrawings. And then some other options about transferring motion studies or animations from SOLIDWORKS, and also table data. We'll okay that. And the last setting in here is whether or not there's a password on the file. Passwords obviously apply an extra layer of security. So if it is a secure document, you can assign a password to it. I'll leave it off for the moment. When we hit okay, SOLIDWORKS processes the file and creates the eDrawing. Once the file has been converted, the eDrawings application is loaded. And you can see here we have our SOLIDWORKS foot assembly. So down in the bottom right here, we have an attachment because we have the step file enabled. And you can see we have the STP or step file. We can turn this on and we've got some options to actually view the attachment, extract the attachment or save it out or delete it. So just an example, if I press view, this loads up into eDrawings as well. And then we have the step file. You can see here the STP file for this full assembly. Very, very useful method, and it's a great time saver. Saves you having to do it from SOLIDWORKS manually. Now, the other method of creating an eDrawing is to use the save as command in SOLIDWORKS. So if we just toggle back to the SOLIDWORKS application, that's my original model. Rather than using the shortcut, for example, if you didn't need to open it necessarily straight away, we can use the regular save as command. And on here, we can choose the eDrawings format. In this case, it's a .EASM file. Choose the location to save, give it a name, and we can save that file. We get the same options. The only difference here is that the file isn't opened automatically. So great if you just want to save a file to send to someone. If you needed to then open that file up manually, to load the eDrawings application, it is a standalone program, just like SOLIDWORKS. We'd find the program and load it up. And then just like any other file, we can choose to open that. Just while we're in here, if you weren't aware, eDrawings is a general purpose CAD viewer. It can open up a whole range of file types from native eDrawings files, SOLIDWORKS files, obviously, neutral formats such as STEP and IGES, and some other proprietary CAD formats as well. So when we open the foot model, you can see here we end up with the same result had we have just published it directly from SOLIDWORKS. Thanks for watching.